Hello everyone, I'm Praveen, faculty of New York City Technologies. Today I'm going to give an electron static timing analysis, part 2. In this lecture, I'm going to discuss on clock skew and its impact on setup and hold timing. And we'll discuss about how to avoid clock skew. We will also discuss about other two aspects of clock skew, which arises in physical design, that is CRPR and CPPR. So coming to clock skew, there are two types of clock skews, positive skew, positive clock skew, negative clock skew. So let's discuss on positive clock skew with an example. So this is a sequential path, sequential logic that exists in a normal digital design. So there are like two flops in this and there's a combo logic in between. This is one red to red path. So clock skew exists in between red to red path. So clock skew is nothing but a delay in the clock network. So there's a primary clock. So from primary clock, we call as a launch clock and it routed to launch clock that is called as a leaf. And then that same clock goes to capture clock. That clock is called as capture clock. In between, there will be a skew. The skew is due to network path delay. This is the launch clock and this is the capture clock, and you can see because of clock path delay there is a skew called T skew. So here if you so because of this skew there is a change in the timing requirement for this kind of sequential logic. So the if you see the timing equation, so this positive skew on the capture clock, if you see, it is improving your setup time. That means it is delaying the capturing of the process data. So that will actually help in meeting the setup time requirement. So positive skew improves setup time. It helps in time borrowing when in required during useful skew implementation during physical design. But there is a problem with the positive skew. It affects hold time. So this is the equation for hold time, and the hold time requirement actually gets impacted because of positive skew. Coming to negative clock skew. So in negative clock skew, the launch clock changes actually. So launch clock is on the capture side. That means like your primary clock will be entering from capture clock. That means on the capture side. So here launch clock is delayed in this negative clock skew, negative clock skew impact. So launch clock is delayed and capture clock comes on the same edge as primary clock. So this is the clock skew between capture clock and launch clock. So because of that, your launch is delayed and capture becomes faster. So because of that, it impacts the timing. So actually your setup time margin will reduce in case of negative skew. So if you have a negative clock skew in the sequential logic in a red to red path, then it is going to fail with a negative clock skew. Okay, so negative skew impacts setup time. But sometimes, like with the help of positive skew path and negative clock skew path, if you have two consecutive paths like that, in case of positive skew, you are at positive clock skew, you are improving the timing in that path. And in case of negative clock skew, it is actually reducing setup time margins in that path. If these two paths are connected back to back, and in negative clock skew path, if combinational logic delay is less, we can actually use this technique, both positive skew and negative skew combined, and we can implement a time borrowing or useful skew technique to meet the timing in a sequential logic path. Okay, negative clock skew improves hold time. Okay, so actually your hold requirement will get better with the negative clock skew. This is the equation for calculating hold time in case of negative clock skew. So how to avoid the clock skew? Okay. So to overcome clock skew in the clock skew, like is there are some advantages in useful skew calculation, but otherwise, if you have a clock skew, it is going to affect your timing. Let's take this example for fixing clock skew. So here your clock must come from the clock must be balanced. So it should come clock should come from a common point, and from there the clock should route to both launch clock launch path and clock capture clock path with same delay. So these two paths are this path and this path is balanced. So if you see the delay from this common point to here and from this point to the capture clock point, the both delays are common. So that means ideally your clock will reach both launch clock and capture clock with the same delay. So you can avoid clock skew like this by balancing the clock. So usually the CTA step in physical design does this clock balancing to overcome clock skew impact. Okay, this is how it looks after balancing. Your clock skew becomes zero. And coming to CRPR, clock reconvergence pessimism removal. So this arises in a path where clock is balanced, where clock network is balanced to avoid unnecessary clock skews, right? So let's take this is the clock network. So there's a primary clock. It's called as a route point. From here, we are routing the clock to clock buffers. These buffers are used for balancing the clock. But due to OCV variations or buffer variations, like if you take these two buffers are two different buffers. Physically, they have different variations. Like ideally, no two buffers behave in the same way. So there will be certainly some variation. Right. So if suppose this buffer is having a little bit more delay compared to this buffer, then you will see a slight variation in the delay in this path. So because of this buffer delay variations, then you will see a slight variation in the clock delays on launch side and capture side. So this delay this delay arises due to the variation in buffer delay. So it is called a CRPR effect, or it is a CRP. So you can call clock reconvergence pessimism. And we use certain techniques to remove this. You cannot remove this, but you have to use this in your timing calculation. So if you include this CRP in your timing calculation and make sure your design works with the CRP, even though CRP exists in the clock path, then we call that as called CRP removal. Okay. CRP is calculated by this equation. CRP is how much CRP you want to apply on your timing calculation. This is generally done with a parameter called derating, timing derating factor. On certain buffers. So how much you need to apply the derating factor, that is calculated by this equation. CRP is equal to max clock path delay minus min clock path delay. Coming to common path pessimism removal. So this is the same example. Let's say there's a primary clock and primary clock is getting routed to consecutive flops. They are called as launch flop and capture flop. Both getting same clock with a common without having any type of clock balancing. And this path is called as, we call this kind of path without any clock, whichever the clock path doesn't require any clock balancing between launch and capture flop. We call that clock path as common path. Okay, so this is the common path between launch and capture clock. So now this is the primary clock, but due to variations in the common path itself, due to OCV variation or a parasitic effect, parasitic variation due to OCV variations, there will be a common path variation for launch clock and capture clock. So these variations we have to include in our required time calculation. So this is going to affect your setup time and hold time. So whenever you are calculating this timing parameters for setup time as well as clock hold time, we use the required time. So required time is going to change for both setup and hold based on the common path delay variation. So this is the equation used for calculating setup CPPR. So setup slack in the max path and setup slack min path. If you subtract both of them, you'll get the CPPR setup, how much you want to apply. So usually this is like a derating factor. You have to, again, this comes under the timing derate. You have to add this timing derate values into your timing calculation. So generally CPPR is taken as a derating value in calculating the required time. Similar equation holds in hold analysis also. Okay, so usually in setup we use min path for calculating required time, whereas in hold analysis we use max path in calculating required times. Okay, so this is about clock skew and it impacts on static timing analysis in sequential logic. Thank you. If you have any questions or suggestions on this lecture, please comment in the comment section.